Back in 1859, the world witnessed the Carrington event, the largest solar flare ever to hit Earth. Massive chaotic scenes broke out all across the world, more like the most dreaded doomsday. But what if it happened today? Well, join us in today's video and let's find out how fragile we've become and how a single coronal mass ejection could crash the crypto market, among many others. Thursday, the 2nd of September, 1859, was meant to be just another day, but apparently, our sun had other ideas. Around 11:18 a.m. on this fateful day, in the town of Red Hill outside London, British astronomer Richard Christopher Carrington focused his telescope on the sun, and what he saw next was the beginning of an event that triggered many terrifying scenes that had never been witnessed before. Carrington recalls that his telescope picked up a singular outbreak of light, which lasted about 5 minutes, but little did he know that the impact would go on to haunt their lives for years. In simple terms, what Carrington saw that morning was a solar flare, and not just an ordinary one. The Carrington event remains the most vicious solar flare that the sun has sent towards us. It had an estimated energy around 10 to the power of 25 joules, or about 100 million megatons of TNT. Consequently, the brightest ever auroras filled the skies. The resulting displays were so bright that residents in Missouri could read at midnight. Gold miners in the Rocky Mountains were deceived, causing most of them to wake up at 1 a.m. in the morning, thinking the sun had risen. Auroras became visible across the tropics regions from Cuba to Panama, and even all the way down to Moreton Bay in Australia. Geomagnetic compasses went crazy and pointed in the wrong direction, making navigation impossible for ships in the ocean. The telegraph lines were disrupted, and most of the machinery supporting the system caught fire. Frederick Royce, a telegraph operator in Washington, D.C., recalls he received a very severe electric shock that left him stunned. Bystanders even saw a spark of fire jump out of Frederick's head. It was a big turmoil, and nobody knew what was happening. But was it a one-time event, or could it happen again? Although solar flares of that magnitude don't occur often, we've more than enough evidence that suggests that the sun could eject superflares capable of unleashing 10 times more energy than the Carrington event. In fact, the Kepler Space Telescope discovered 10 sun-like stars that released 36 superflares with an enormous level of energy that's 100 times greater than what we witnessed in 1859. So perhaps we're much closer to another Carrington event than we think. But what would be our fate if that happened today? For sure, there would be many people who'd get stunned in an instant like Frederick. But that's just the tip of the iceberg, as the consequences would be many times worse than what we witnessed in the Carrington event. Humanity have become pretty dependent on technology and electricity since that X-type solar flare wreaked havoc on our planet in 1859. To start with, if we got hit by a solar flare like that today, our world would look very much different from what it looks like at the moment. Chaos will become the order of the day, and we'll literally enter a kind of modern Stone Age. The very first segment that would get a serious hit is our communication system. Satellites, transmitters, and communication devices, all of these systems would be crippled by a single shot of solar flare. Satellites on orbit will lose their way, and most of them could even re-enter Earth's atmosphere and burn up due to the enormous push of the coronal ejection. Without a doubt, most of our GPS systems will be completely destroyed as well. The next infrastructural damage will be our electricity network. Solar flares induce current in everything and anything that conducts electricity. This could be the atmosphere, the ocean, or some rare types of rock. But of course, the conductivity level would definitely be higher with electrical infrastructures like power grids, high voltage transformers, and electricity distribution stations. Should this happen, the connections of these infrastructure will be breached, and our current power generation capacity of 26,823,200 terawatt hours would be wiped out in one clean sweep. And the ripple effect would bite hard into other sectors, including banking, healthcare, manufacturing, transportation, among many others. This would eventually trickle down to affect most of our basic amenities that contribute to the smooth sailing of our day-to-day lives. Communications between airplanes and air traffic control would be lost. Train operation would be disrupted. Ships on the high waters will be left stranded without any idea of where they are or where they're headed to. And worst of all, the breakdown in the communication systems would make it impossible to reach out to their various control centers. This will more or less cripple the global supply chains, which would in turn affect the supplies of food and other basic household and industrial goods. Driving around town would be incredibly difficult as well, considering the fact that general panic will unfold. But that's just the beginning of our woes. Airline passengers in the air will be struck with a year's dose of radiation at once. Astronauts in space will suffer even worse consequences, and the chances of humans suffering cancer will increase by tenfold as the intense radiation makes it spread through the nooks and crannies of our Earth. NASA would have a hard time communicating and controlling satellites and spacecraft on orbit. Elon Musk's Starlink project and all that it accomplished till that day would be gone. However, the worst is still yet to come. Our atmosphere will become saturated with energy particles, and the Earth's magnetic field will be stretched beyond reasonable limits. Of course, all of these happenings will come with severe financial implications as well. The estimated potential cost of a Carrington-level event would result in a $2.6 trillion loss in revenue for North American power industry alone. A global blackout affecting 66% of the U.S. population would lead to a daily domestic economic loss of $41.5 billion and an additional deficit of $7 billion resulting from international supply chain disruptions. But even worse is the fact that the technologies that support the financial and stock markets will be affected as well. But the biggest ever stock market crash that happened in 1929 would be nothing compared to this event. If a Carrington-like event would happen again today, the consequences will extend far beyond the financial market. Even the crypto market will take a deep plunge, and all the digital assets will either be wiped off or become worthless. Banks will be shut and the ATM machines won't work. So it's safe to say that millions of individuals will perhaps lose their life savings or get into serious trouble. A great panic will unfold with almost nobody to know what to do. Without internet connection, live broadcasts, and telecommunication, we will find ourselves in a modern Stone Age. However, the government will suffer even worse circumstances. Apart from inventing unconventional ways to reach and appease their citizens to keep calm, governments will lose most of their revenue streams as well. Government institutions will be incapacitated. The military's communication systems will be damaged, making it impossible to help citizens during the crisis. Radar will be disrupted, leaving all GPS-enabled military weapons useless. A few hours into the event, a significant section of our planet will be thrown into complete darkness. But that wouldn't count for anything considering the extent of the damage that would have been done already. The lifestyle we got used to is gone by that time, and the government would need to adapt to the new situation and reinvent all their procedures to help citizens on the go. The population of Mother Earth will face its biggest ever crisis, and nobody will have an exact plan or scenario for what's to come. Taking the fact into consideration that all of our modern tech can be gone due to the solar flare, humanity will face a 4 to 10 years period that is needed to get through the toughest consequences. But rebuilding our lives will most likely need a lot more time and effort than that. And it could be closer than we think, as we are in an active solar phase which will most likely peak in 2025, and upcoming bursts are expected, but the danger they pose can't be predicted. However, just recently, scientists have found a monstrous sunspot that has doubled its size in 24 hours and is currently 3 times bigger than Earth. It is located at the most dangerous place for us, around the sun's equator. So we might have the awful chance to see what if the Carrington event happened today.